Hello everyone, today's my topic is the second most important variance is labor variance. Labor variances means when actual labor cost are different from standard labor cost, the labor variances arise. It may be favorable or unfavorable, as like material variance. The variances in labor cost may occur because of two main factors, same as material variance, difference in actual rates and standard rates of labor. And the second one, the variation in actual time taken by workers and the standard time allotted to them for performing a job or an operation. Now, the calculation of variance, labor variances are calculated under two heads, just like material variances. Number one, only one type of labor is used, and when more than one type of labor is used. Labor variances formula are same just like material variances, where we use quantity in material variance in place of quantity. We use the term time, and when we use the term of price in material variances, here we use rate. Now, number one type of variance, when only one type of labor is used. Here it can be solved or it can be calculated by three types: labor cost variance, labor time efficiency variance, or labor or wage rate variance. Now, labor cost variance, this is the difference between the standard labor cost specified for the activity achieved and actual labor cost incurred. It may be favorable and unfavorable. Reason for that, it may arise due to difference between standard time and actual time, and difference between standard rate and actual rate. And the formula, labor cost variance equal to standard cost minus actual cost. Here, labor cost variance equal to standard time multiply standard rate minus actual time multiply actual rate. We can show it also in by short form, or its abbreviations are LCV equal to ST multiply SR minus AT multiply AR. Now, labor time or efficiency variance. This is that portion of the labor cost variance which is due to the difference between labor hours specified and actual labor hours expended. It may be favorable and unfavorable. Reason for that, this variance is usually caused by poor working conditions, defective plant and machinery, inefficient workers, use of defective materials, time wasted factors like waiting for materials, tools, etc., or machine breakdown. And the formula for the calculate for this labor time or efficiency variance equal to standard rate multiplied by standard time minus actual time, and its abbreviations are LEV equal to SR multiply ST minus AT. Now, labor rate variance, this is that portion of the labor cost variance which is due to the difference between the standard rate specified and the actual rate paid. It may be favorable or unfavorable. Reason for that, usual reasons are change in the basic wage payment, use of different methods of wage payment, unscheduled overtime, new workers not being paid at full rates, etc. And formula for this labor rate variance equal to actual time multiplied by standard rate minus actual rate. Its abbreviations are LRV equal to AT multiplied by SR minus AR. And verification for that, LCV, labor cost variance, equal to labor efficiency variance plus labor rate variance. Now, idle time variance, this variance represents that portion of the labor efficiency variance which is due abnormal idle time, such as time lost due to machine breakdown, power failure, strike, etc. It is calculated by valuing idle hours at standard rate. And formula for this, labor idle time variance
equal to idle time multiply standard rate. Here are a note for this. Idle hours represents a loss. Therefore, idle time variance is always unfavorable or adverse because it's not favorable for the firm. Now, more than one type of labor is used. If two or more types of labor are appointed in the production process, like skilled and unskilled, men, women, and boy, etc. In such a situation, the two additional variances are to be calculated, which are as follows: labor mix variance or gang composition variance. This variance is similar to material mix variance. It arises only when more than one grade of workers are employed and the composition of actual grade of workers differ from those specified due to shortage of a particular grade of labor or some other reason. It is calculated with the help of following formula: labor mix variance equal to SR standard rate multiply RST minus AT. RST means revised standard time minus actual time, where RST equal to standard time of particular labor multiply total of actual time mix divided by total of standard mix time. Now, possibilities for calculating labor mix variance. There are two possibilities for calculating labor mix variance. If actual time expended is equal to total standard time, in such a situation, labor mix variance and labor efficiency variance will be equal, which shows there is no variance due to mix ratio. And number two, if actual time expended is not equal to the total standard time, in such a situation, labor efficiency variance and labor mix variance would not be equal, which respects that variance arises due to labor mix. In this case, labor sub-efficiency variance is also calculated with the help of the following formula: labor sub-efficiency variance equal to standard rate multiply standard time minus revised standard time. Labor yield variance, it is just like material yield variance and arises due to the difference between yield that should have been obtained by actual time utilized on production and actual yield obtained. It can be computed by applying the following formula, and the formula is labor yield variance equal to standard cost per unit. First, we will calculate standard cost per unit equal to actual yield minus standard yield from actual time, or SC per unit. Its abbreviations is SC per unit multiply AY minus SY from actual time, where SC per unit equal to total standard wages upon total standard yield. SY for actual time equal to standard yield multiply total actual time divided by total standard time. Thank you.